Well, Seneca is the head games maker. So his responsibilities include everything from the presentation before the actual games to creating the arena, the virtual arena in which they fight, whatever the landscape will be, whatever the challenges will be there, the weapons that are laid out. He needs to assess all of the tributes that are picked and to see what their talents are or their lack of talents. Really all in the end to create some form of entertainment, sick entertainment that that he leads from his game center, which is a virtual center where everything can be controlled by him and sort of his team. I gathered from the books that the arenas take a long time to build, that they're not just a process that's put together in the last few days. And so it's a controllable environment that Seneca has the complete control over. If he wants to start a fire, like say in the first one, he can start a fire to send the tributes together to fight. If he wants to, set traps. If he wants to change the weather, he can make it colder, make it hotter. He can make it more difficult because in the end, like he says, we want to see the tributes struggle. We want to see them fight for their lives. And the way to do that is to have complete control of their environment and the things that they would need to survive. Katniss Everdeen is she's a girl who grew up in District 12, which is one of the poorest districts, if not the poorest district. Lost her father in a mining accident. And has had to fend for herself and her family ever since, and has found ways of doing that from things she was taught by having to hunt in the wild outside of District 12, which is basically Appalachia. And in the woods and in the hills there, she's learned how to survive in of sorts. President Snow, he's a bit of a mystery because in the first book, because and in the first movie, because he's older, he's been around and has, he's almost old enough to see how the Capitol had to pay for the rebellion, how close it came. It's familiar to him, and I think Katniss represents a challenge to him. I think she's a threat to him because she's a reminder of that rebellion. Katniss Everdeen is played by Jennifer Lawrence, who is an amazing young actress, very talented, very smart girl, very funny girl. I read this book and immediately thought she would be great for the role. She's kind of perfect in my mind because she's she herself is she's pretty. She's got a tough edge to her, but that tough edge, that she's also very there's something very soft and delicate that is there that you want Katniss to have because, like I said, you want to hope for that to stay, despite her having to be tough. Donald Sutherland is an amazing actor, a legend, and I was so lucky to have a couple of scenes with him. And it was great because those scenes were outside of the book, and you really got to see what was going on, as Katniss is fighting for her life and the things that are going on in the games. Gary and the casting director, Deborah Zane, who is incredible, has thought of some really, really great people to fill out roles that maybe they wouldn't always do, because on paper they look small, but really, they shine with this writing and with Gary. And I get to do a great scene with Stanley Tucci, who I have been a fan of my whole career and before. And he's a great guy. he could bring out Caesar. I think when I heard that, it was perfect. And one of the more special or more unique castings was I thought the idea of Lenny Kravitz as Senna. And it's not somebody you maybe would have thought of right away, but when I heard that, I thought that's perfect. It's a quiet, stylish, cool dude who would be perfect for Seneca. first of all, they should be excited because it's a great story. I think the fans who already have read the books know that. Anyone who hasn't read the books, I mean, this is an amazing story. An easy story to get excited about to put to film. But beyond that, you've got an amazing team putting together a great film that's a really exciting, fast-moving film that, is at once entertaining as it is politically sophisticated and moving, you know, and intriguing. It's really kind of the perfect storm of a movie right now.